show them what you can do, and soon they will know that the day has come. Late into the night I hear it storming, and into the rain is what I pray, and I'm hoping. Now I feel the pressure of the city, oh, how it eats me whole. So many names and faces, sleepless nights spent in unknown places, and every day I walk straight into the great unknown.
Where the fuck do I even begin, dude? My Hero Academia, after 10 years of serialization, has finally ended. And as someone who's been following this show for the past 6 years, well, let me tell you that this hit me way fucking harder than I ever expected it to. Wow, I genuinely feel such a sense of loss. I feel like I've lost something that I'll never get back, and in a way, I have. This show and its characters mean so much to me. I'd say I can't describe in words how much it means to me, but that's literally what I'll be trying to do in this video, so, yeah, I don't know what I'm trying to say. My thoughts are a mess right now, and if you couldn't tell, this video is not scripted. You can't really write your feelings down like this, or at least I can't, so I didn't bother. I'll just fucking pour my heart out, or whatever they say in this video, but just yapping about how much this shit means to me. Because let me tell you, this show has left an impact on me, and I would go as far to say that I would not be the same person I am today if I hadn't watched this. And I am eternally grateful to Horikoshi that I got the chance to witness something like this. I started watching My Hero Academia a few months after my mother passed away. I watched it on her phone, actually. I watched it on YouTube, and you know, nowadays we got MusaAsia and other channels like that where they're like officially and legally streaming anime, but back in 2018 we didn't have that, so I had to watch a Nightcore-ified the dub. I watched the dub in it was like sped up for some reason. It played at like 1.5x speed, and it sounded like Nightcore, and yeah, who the fuck cares? Little me fucking loved it. And I vividly remember watching the first episode on my mother's phone at like around 6 p.m. And by the ending, I was just fucking floored. All my little speech to Deku about how he too can be a hero has still stuck with me after all these years, and I don't think I'll ever forget it. I still go back and rewatch that scene. I've lost count of how many times I've fucking seen that shit. It's really kind of awesome how, fix something fictional, something that's never happened. People who never existed. Class 1A didn't exist. They're not real people, but they fucking left an impact on me as if they were. Back in 2018, I joined a few group chats on Instagram, thanks to watching My Hero Academia. Back then, I didn't really have many people to like call friends or, well, I'm really good friends with people I used to call friends back then, but back then we weren't close. I wouldn't call us close. I did not have people who would talk to me outside of the usual hello and hi's outside of school. That was it. That was the only other human interaction I had with people who weren't family, you know? Yeah, after my mom died, it was just me and my dad, and he wasn't home a lot of the time. And as like a 12-year-old, you don't really got much else to do if you don't have friends and no one's home. So this was my only opportunity, I guess. And God, let me tell you, joining those group chats was one of the best decisions I've ever made. I'm unfortunately not in contact with like 90% of the people from that group chat, but I don't regret forming connections with these people because back then they were all I had. And the conversations we had and the bonds we forged and deepened, they're still real and they will always live on within me, I guess. There's this friend I had who, they were on Tumblr a lot. They were really active on Tumblr. And there's still the reason I still have Tumblr. I don't use Tumblr, but every few weeks I message them, just hoping they'd message me back one day, because it's been 3 years since we last spoke. They just kind of went off the grid one day and we never spoke since. And I miss you, Kai. I hope you just forgot your password or something like that. I hope you're living a happy life. Oh well, it's not like I lost contact with everyone. I kept in contact with a few of them. Yeah, I've been talking a lot recently to one of them, one of the people from that group chat actually, and it feels nice. It feels really fucking nice to reconnect with people you haven't talked to much in years, and we talk like nothing changed. It's been 6 years. We met when we were 17. We're like fucking... So sorry, we met when we were 12, and now I'm 17. I'm 17 years old. That's insane. I'm gonna be 18 next year. I'm gonna be a legal adult next year. And yeah, it really is just crazy. Throughout, like, my entire time watching this show, I didn't really find any characters who I completely related with. Like, yeah, there were a few who had, like, certain character traits who I really related to, but I didn't really find any literally me characters in this show. I would really like to be as optimistic and an amazing person as Deku, but... Wow, I just realized how fucking corny this entire video is. Anyways, yeah, I used to have a friend... I have a friend who used to be afraid of Todoroki, for lack of a better word, back when we were kids, because his backstory reminded them of their childhood. And after a year or two of this, they eventually learned to like let go of this part of themselves and learned to like this character. And in isolation, since you don't really know the person like I do, this might not sound like much to you, but I'm so proud of them. I was so proud of them, and I still am. And seeing how much Todoroki grew and how much happier he is now compared to the beginning of the series, it fills me with pride and joy. It really does make me really happy. And my friend's doing really well nowadays too. And I always love to see that. And speaking of growth, you can't not mention Bakugo. I genuinely think Bakugo's character development and the whole redemption arc thingy is one of the best in shonen. That's my opinion, and I genuinely believe that Bakugo's development was so, so well done, man. And God, I love it. I love it. I love it. God, this show has so many highlights for me. If I were to name a few at the top of my head, I think almost everyone would mention the All Might speech to Deku in season one first, where he like told him that he could be a hero. That's a series highlight right there. We have All Might versus the Nomu at the end of season one. God, I remember when All Might said the words, "Your quirk is shock absorption, not nullification," right?
He said your quirk was only shock absorption, not nullification. That means there's a limit to what you can take, right?
And fuck, I remember just jumping and just jumping out of my seat and just jumping around my entire room because that was so raw. That is cinema. That was cinema, dude. And jumping to season two, the entire sports festival arc, amazing, peak fiction, Deku vs. Todoroki, another fucking highlight of the show. And then the whole Stain arc, that was amazing too. Season three, the camp arc, the one where Deku fought Overhaul. The one where Deku fought Muscular. Amazing. It just, there are so many highlights. The Shie Hasekai arc or the Overhaul arc, amazing. The school festival arc, beautiful. My Villain Academia, while a bit disappointing in the anime, I read the manga, so I don't really have any problems with it. It was amazing. Like, there are so many other ones. Seasons in the entirety of season 6, the entirety of season 7. Not to mention the movies and the OVAs. This show has just so much to offer. It's amazing. And so, yeah, it's been a great 6 years for me, and I'm really gonna miss it. I'm sorry this video is such a mess to sit through. I can't really form very coherent thoughts right now. My country's in quite the pickle, you might say. I won't get too much into it, but if you would like to learn more, I will leave some things in the description. A lot of people are dying. The government's killing a lot of people, and you're not here for that. So if you're interested, it's gonna be in the description, but you're here for My Hero Academia, not this. Yeah, all I can say is just, from the bottom of my heart, thank you, Horikoshi. Thank you, Bones. Thank you for allowing us to be a part of this journey, and thank you for such a beautiful ending. That's all I can really say, really honestly.